guys, my name is Crystal and welcome to my YouTube channel. Welcome all, welcome new. Alexa, what's the time, please?
The time is 7:16 AM.
Alexa, what's the date today?
Today is Tuesday the 22nd of March.
Alexa, the weather?
Right now in Rochester, it's 8 degrees Celsius with clear skies and sun. Today's forecast is mostly sunny weather with a high of 17 degrees and a low of 4 degrees.
Right guys, I've got up early today because I've got to go to the dentist. I got up at 6 a.m. this morning, fed the cats, fed Max, made myself a cup of coffee. I haven't put the television on yet. I've walked Max early. I walked him about 6:30. It's nice and sunny outside. You can tell it's going to be a really nice day, but the grass was wet with the morning dew and slightly cold, but it will get warmer, I expect, this afternoon, this morning. So I've got to be able to get ready to go out to the dentist for a scrape and polish. I'll be quite honest with you, I've woken up feeling terrible. I had a really bad tummy ache. And I feel a bit hot, but I've paid £48 for a scrape and polish, and if I cancel it, what will happen is they will keep the money and I will lose £48, and I can't afford to lose £48, so I've dragged myself up even though I feel terrible, and I'm going to the dentist this morning. Last night was pretty much the same as every other night. Sat indoors by myself, watching what's on the telly, playing the Spades online game, and just snuggling down on the sofa with Max. The thing is, guys, at my age, I can't really find somebody that wants to settle down and have relationships. It's either young lads wanting to show off that they can go with an older woman, and they want like a mummy figure that pays for all their stuff and looks after them. And I'm 53 and I just am tired myself. I'm not full of energy like I was even 10 years ago. I just feel really, really tired, and I just want to just settle down now and like get on with life, basically. I had an offer yesterday from someone on WhatsApp. I've met this guy before at Lansdowne Court. He's Bolivian, he's got a shaven head, he's quite large, and he wanted to come round to my flat here in Rochester yesterday, right? I don't want one night stands. I am not a porn star. The last time, when he came to Lansdowne Court, he treated me like I was a porn star. Up and down, all over the flat, and he took me round the corner of near Chatham Railway Station and bought me a punnet of strawberries. I've just wondered why my mum keeps buying strawberries all of a sudden. And then I remembered this Bolivian guy at Lansdowne Court took me round the corner from Chatham Railway Station and bought me some strawberries. Cheap, reduced strawberries. I'll be quite honest with you, I gave in to my loneliness at Lansdowne Court, and I was meeting people just for company. And these men were abusing me, right? They were taking advantage of me. Pushing and pulling me all around the flat. Some of them were smacking my bottom and pulling my hair like a donkey. Like, come on. And I don't want that, right? And if I can't get that, I'd rather go without. So can these people stop trying to treat me like I was treated at Lansdowne Court, please, because it's not going to happen. Don't contact me if you're just looking for someone to, you know, push around and abuse, because I'm not interested. Alexa, can you put LBC Radio on, please?
LBC London, from Global Power.
Some £500 million that that ship is worth. And the Guardian tells us that $17 billion of dollars, I'm sorry, of global assets linked to Russians with alleged ties to Putin. There is a picture of Roman Abramovich on the front page of that. I need to tell you, of course, he's always denied any close association with Vladimir Putin. The Eye has the story we just talked about, Russian troops turn on protesters. Similar theme for the Times, Putin threatens civilians to break Mariupol's spirit. Escape from Mariupol is the front page of the Metro, and the LBC website as it combines both stories, really. 50 Ukrainian orphans due to fly to UK, stranded in Poland. This is all after a so-called paperwork blunder, a story we're going to look at later in the show. Right, let's get Jason, who's in Millbourne Port, I've reached, to talk about Nazanin Zaghari-Ratcliffe. Where does that put you if you're near Millbourne Port? Where's that near that I might have heard of? Good morning.
Near Sherborne.
Oh, right, you're in Dorset. Are you in Dorset or Somerset?
It's Dorset. I'm just on the border, yeah.
On the border, sir. Okay, what are you going to tell me about Nazanin Zaghari-Ratcliffe?
She didn't come across as a sort of victim. She came across very politically orientated. Did you not think that?
I'm loath to ascribe any negative sentiment, because the poor woman has just endured 6 years in jail. What I will say is there might have been a degree of more gratitude, possibly.
Okay. Do you think that she'll give the money from the Hollywood blockbuster and the book deal to a charity, or should she keep it?
I have no idea, and it's difficult to say. What do you? I would hope that you do a split, some for a charity for refugees or those who are held in torture or whatever, and some for herself. What do you say?
I say she should give all the money back, because she's, unfortunately, as a lot of people say, if you don't go somewhere, you don't get in trouble in the first place. So she hasn't gone